Okay. Well, we got five of you already. Holy shit. Who do we have? And hey, everybody. Billy, Billy. Bonjour, bonjour. Hello, hello. Just moving some shit out of the way. I have major cleaning and organizing plans for Friday. Next week's streams might be so much more organized. Probably not, but might be. Could be. Also, thank you for the follow, Figment Pudding. You followed the last day that I streamed, but I don't know if it was during my stream. It might have been maybe after I raided last week. So I don't think I noticed until now. So thank you for the follow. I don't know that you're watching right now, but if you are, then now you know. How you doing, Billy? Oops. I'm not too bad. So I'm drawing something from Walking Dead. This was actually a kind of a not really a formal request, but somebody on Facebook commented on, I think it might have been the Munsters, and they said, "Have you ever drawn Walking Dead?" And I thought, "No, but maybe I will." And I decided I'll do it right away, since it is in keeping with this month's horror themes. Thank you. I'm speaking of the promo. The promo might give you a pretty good idea of who's going to be taking center stage in this particular drawing. I have an idea. I have a pose in my head, but not one that I've really. I haven't completely figured it. To get in there Are you a Walking fan? Walking fan. Are you a Walking Dead fan, Billy? I like the show. I've never read the comic, but I feel like I want to at some point read the comic. Complaint for the show is pacing issues. I did watch it as a drawing show, and I never really had an issue with the pacing, but again, drawing show makes a big difference. That head is broken, or the neck is broken, I should say. We'll fix that in a minute. Let's just get the broad strokes of things in here first. Does everyone have both hands on the sword or not? Maybe I do. Have you just not gotten back to the show, Billy? Or was it where you're not really digging it? I think the second season, that's with like the barn and stuff, right? Let me ask you this, were you watching it live or were you watching it on like Netflix? Because a lot of people complained about the pacing in that one being really slow and stuff. And again, I'm not really in a position to properly judge because I was multitasking with it, so I wasn't necessarily getting... If I was sitting there watching it, I might have gotten restless with it. But I also wonder how much of a difference binging versus week to week would be. Because I felt like the slow burn kind of helped with the suspense of that season. But if I was waiting every week to get back to it, I don't think I would feel that same way. So when was the barn then? Was that the third season? Okay, I think I'm pretty happy with this pose. She's on a mound. Speaking of the promo, Billy, I just realized I never posted that on Discord today, did I? Posted everywhere else. I was a little late to post it today because I was in the pitch sessions for the day, for the term that's ending. And they ran a little late. Oh, it was the second season. Okay. So does that mean they actually watched three seasons then, if you're remembering the CDC? Or is the CDC part of the barn season? I feel like they didn't spend... Because didn't a season end with them finding the CDC and it's like deserted or something? And it doesn't really go anywhere? Or do they spend a lot more time there than I'm remembering? Okay. But again, I think at the end, right? Like, isn't that the whole goal, is to get there? So I don't know then, Billy, if you even would have met Michonne. I kind of feel like she doesn't come in until season 3. I feel like she takes a while. And then when she's there, she's like, awesome. Probably my favorite character of the whole series. Or am I wrong? Did she come in sooner? I'm trying to figure out what her vest looks like here. edges here and there on the design, but not too much. Okay. So that's their goal in season one, and then they make it happen in season two, but then I don't think the payoff really happens till season three, if I'm remembering correctly. Studs on her belt. I did, yes. What'd you think of it? I liked it quite a bit. I do have a note, but it'll be hard to get into it without spoilers for anybody that hasn't watched it. But I liked it overall. What'd you think? I can definitely see why it would be a very divisive episode among people. I'm gonna change the angle of it just because I'm hiding so much of her face. I don't think I want to do that. Let's tilt her back a little bit. If this was in a comic, I would be all about low angle face, I feel like. But since this is sort of a kind of pin-up-y poster image, I want to see a bit more of her face. Gives me a bit more room to exaggerate the expression a bit too. love and hate drawing dreadlocks at the same time. I think we're on the same page there, Billy. I mean, they didn't do everything that they said, but they definitely did some of it. And I just kind of, basically, there's a shot at the end there where she's walking up the steps of the courthouse, and I thought that was taking us to what our last scene was going to be, and instead it was just over. So I liked that scene a lot, and I liked pretty much everything about it, but I don't think that we had to, we shouldn't have had to choose between that and a real payoff to everything that had been set up. And it didn't have to be, you know, all the stuff that she thought it was going to be. It could have still been their own thing, but it could have been, that's why I thought that's where the courtroom was going to take us, but. Yeah, that was honestly my biggest issue with it. The other thing kind of annoyed me, but I was just kind of like, oh, if they do season two, then maybe we'll kind of still get that resolution and stuff. But that one is, I felt like it was very unnecessary, very forced, and it is exactly what she told them not to do. I thought that was the most egregious example of that, like you were saying. But I liked all the commentary and stuff that came out of it. I thought it was all, like, really spot on. I think what's unfortunate with the lack of payoff, though, is that they were dealing with some real-world stuff that felt very appropriate to use She-Hulk to tackle. And then they abandoned it. And they kind of had some comments on almost like toxic fandom and stuff, which I thought was also relevant and made sense for She-Hulk as well, but we could have had both. I don't see why we couldn't have had both. Gloves has one of these holes in it, but it does now. Because I have spoken. I'll make sure to get the hilt right in case there's any Star Wars level Walking Dead fans out there ready to give me shit. I did. I honestly didn't love that teaser. Like, I am actually looking forward to the show because I like Mindy Kaling, and I was very unsure about it when they first announced it, not realizing that they were going like for a fully adult show. And once I heard that, I was very on board. And I like the art style and stuff. So I'm very into it. I didn't think the trailer itself was anything that great, but I did like, I liked it enough, and I'm excited for it. she ever at any point has it, but I'm doing it anyway, damn it. I actually have a Michonne action picture of an action figure up on my screen over there to help with some of the outfits. Sometimes the shots in the show just don't like show off the costumes the way you need them to, but the action figures usually will, so hopefully they're accurate. So again, same page by the sounds of it. I think it was just like they were going for a joke with the trailer, which is fine, but it's not probably what the show itself is really going to be. I mean, maybe the vibe of it, but... Are you a Friday the 13th fan at all, Billy? I bought the whole series. And have been working my way through it since Sunday. And interesting. I think I've seen all of them at one point or another. There's only one that I'm not 100% sure if I had seen before or not. I definitely recognize parts of it, but it might just be as a fan, knowing, you know, just being a movie geek, sometimes you pick up things. Okay. Been an interesting watch, especially because the first eight, like, they made eight movies in the span of 9 years. And it's kind of interesting to see, like, the production value just get more and more polished progressively. Almost like watching a time lapse of film stock. I don't know. Well, I would say more and more polished in terms of production value, but not necessarily in terms of writing and stuff. But if we're being honest, it's not like any of them are award-winning. Like, the writing in all of them is not the best. But they're fun if you like slasher movies, if you're in the mood for them. It's funny too, because what their real claim to fame, those early ones, was just showing like on-screen gore and stuff. No one had seen such a thing, but they're actually like super tame compared to now. Like, it's actually not that gory, all things considered. here's the interesting with that one. It's actually not. That's what I realized when I was watching it. Because here's the thing with that first movie, right? If you're watching it for the first time in 1980, and spoilers for 1980s Friday the 13th, if anybody cares. But so the killer is not Jason. It's Pamela Voorhees, it's his mom. And we don't meet Pamela until the end of the movie. And we only have like a throwaway line of dialogue really mentioning about this kid that supposedly drowned in the lake like 20 years ago or whatever. And so Pamela shows up and you're like, you have no idea who it is. And she just says, I'm Mrs. Voorhees. And then she like, and then not too long after that, she tells you that her son went to the camp and that he drowned and that his name is Jason and today's his birthday and all this kind of stuff. And she basically tells you the entire backstory of herself, and that's how you realize she's the killer and you understand her motive and all that stuff. But there's not really any real twist to be had because the entire movie, you know there's a killer on the loose, you don't know who it is, and you're not given any selection of characters to choose from to try to guess who the killer is. And you're not given enough information to potentially even extrapolate that it could be Pamela. So there's really not a twist. There's not much of a mystery. There's not much of a reveal, really, at all. But if you watch the show, if you watch the movie for the first time several years later, as both of us would have done, then it is a good twist. Because you go into the movie expecting it to be Jason, because Jason's so iconic. And most people don't realize that he wasn't the killer in that first movie. So you go in thinking, like, oh, it's Jason. And then it does work as a twist. But it's almost like a happy accident in a way, you know? Which I thought was interesting watching it. That's true. Like, that, I guess, would be... I guess you could consider that a twist, but it's not... I think I always looked at it as a twist in a more typical sense. I'm like, oh, never would have guessed she was the killer. And then you realize that you're never really given the chance to even think about it. But like I said, it does work as one, just not in the way that I always thought of it. Yeah, because it's sort of just like, here's the killer, and by the way, here's why. But no, the little tiny old lady is a valid point, though. For sure. So I'm sure that did shock people at the time. more than I may be giving credit for. But I do think that it feels a bit more like of a twist if you're watching it for the first time now, which is ironic because that's usually the exact opposite, right? Like, I knew Vader was Luke's father long before I ever watched Star Wars. And I wasn't even that old when I watched Star Wars for the first time. I think I was probably about 12. So they do mention the kid drowning, but they don't get too into it. So, like, there is a bit of, like, oh, they mentioned that, but, like, not a... Am I right that the last season of Walking Dead has already come out? It's just not on Netflix yet? Do we know? I think it's already been on AMC. Yeah, exactly. I watched number 8, Jason Takes Manhattan, right before I went live here tonight, and that might be the first one I ever saw. I remember seeing that one as a kid with a friend, and I remember seeing Jason Lives with my dad as a kid, and I don't know which one came first. And my memory as a kid was that Jason Takes Manhattan was awesome. I would say of the ones I've watched so far, it's definitely the weakest, and it has a really weird ending. I don't know what the hell they were thinking with that ending. And I haven't watched the next one yet. I have a feeling... I've seen the next one, but not since I was really little. I have a feeling they kind of just disregard the ending in the next one. They kind of pretend like it never happened. Because I don't know how you even come back from that. But if they actually find a way to use it and build off of it, I'm very impressed. I think it's funny too, they don't really seem to acknowledge any kind of supernatural element to Jason until Jason Lives. Like, the fourth one is called The Final Chapter, and then there's another one that comes out where Jason's actually not the killer. You think it's Jason, it looks like Jason, but you find out it was somebody posing as Jason. And then they resurrect him in the next one, and then that's called Jason Lives, and that's when they're like... talking about you know, like, oh, he's stronger than ever now and all this kind of stuff. But it's like, in number 3, he takes an axe to the head and then sits up on a hospital gurney in the next movie. You clearly already had some shit going on there. Hey, Carlos. Okay. But do we know if it I hope it still comes to Netflix, and that is the last season, right? Also, thank you for looking that up. Are you a fan, Carlos? Are you not a big horror guy, though, are you, Carlos? I think I might have scarred you with my horror lecture last term. Thank you. At the end. At the end of the first one, he, as a kid, he jumps out, but that turns out to be a dream sequence, which I think is what inspired them to make Jason the Killer in the second one. But they had to kind of undo that so that they could make him an adult. That's all we need. We need dead body piles here. Imply the other stuff. Alright, let's start inking it. It had been a long time since I'd seen most of them myself. I put a couple of them that were on Netflix on the background a few years ago while I was drawing. I think on like Halloween Day. But I've been actually sitting and watching them this time. Try and take a bit of a break now that I'm done my horror comic, which should be live tomorrow, by the way, guys. And Combat Fairies and the stuff I was doing for Brad and everything. Ironically, pretty much the day I finished the horror comic, I found out I'm going to do a music video for somebody, which I'm excited about, but I was like, the timing, I was like, well, really? Okay, so not much of a break after all, but... Trying to be chill for at least a few days this week before I dive into that. But I am excited for it. It will be a fun gig. It's just the timing is kind of uncanny as well. Another weird thing with Manhattan is I was actually really impressed how tight they managed to keep the continuity up to that point. I mean, there's a couple of recasted characters here and there and stuff, and like, but it's just that, like, you know, they always would, a lot of them pick up immediately where the previous one left off. They're often reusing footage from the previous movie to kind of set things up, and they'll usually make sure that if Jason was last left dead in this way, he's found that way again. And they do some really blatant, weird continuity errors in this one, where, like, you see a flashback to Jason drowning, and he's got a full head of hair, and he's not at all deformed, and I'm just like, what? And I think I know where they were going with it, because he does appear deformed in a different flashback, so I think there is a reason for it, kind of, but it's, like, it's a little muddled, and then when the ending happens, it kind of contradicts that as well. Another reason I didn't like the ending. Yeah, they were talking about doing like the rumor for the longest time was that after Freddy vs. Jason, they were going to do Freddy vs. Jason vs. Ash. And I don't know if there was ever any validity to that or not, but I would have been so down for it. There's also like a lot of humor in the Friday the 13th movie, not to the extent of Evil Dead, but kind of makes sense. They're not that tonally off. Oh, is it? Is it in Jason Goes to Hell? That's the next one on my list. They switched distributors after Manhattan, and it moves over to New Line. And I remember that the end of Jason Goes to Hell teases Freddy Krueger, which is what got everybody talking about the possibility of doing a Freddy versus Jason movie. But it took quite a while before they actually did it. So it wouldn't surprise me if that's the same one that. If it's in one of the ones I've already seen, though, I definitely missed it. I saw Halloween Ends, by the way. Very conflicted on it. I was talking about it in class yesterday, I guess. I didn't hate it, but it felt like a very odd choice. Looking forward to it. That's another one that I remember really liking when I saw it, but I would have been. What year is that one? 93, I think. So I was like 9. Or maybe not even that. Or like maybe 8. Even, depending on when exactly I saw it. Probably the only Friday the 13th movie I saw when it was fairly new. I rented it. My mom was off doing something or other, so just me and my dad that night with dad's friend, family friend Rob, and we rented Jason Goes to Hell. And I have a couple really vivid memories from it, but most of it I don't really remember at all. I don't know if Carlos is still with us, but like I said, I don't think Carlos is a horror fan. So hearing me say I watched Jason Goes to Hell when I was 8 or 9. Maybe just flabbergasted right now. Or maybe after 2 terms of me, I was like, no, that tracks. That makes sense. Stupid asthma cough will not go away. You remember what the first horror movie was that you saw, Billy? Also, by the way, I do not remember what the first one I saw was. So I won't blame you if you don't have an answer. I know that the first movie I ever cried in was a horror movie, but it wasn't because I was scared. It was because it was about giant killer rats, but there was this one rat that was like the good rat, which was also the white rat, which in hindsight is kind of racist undertones, but and when that rat died, I lost it. But I do kind of take pride that it was a horror movie was the first one to give me the waterworks. I definitely would have watched that at a really young age. I actually remember like Science World had a... I mean, I was only 2 when that movie came out. So I'm sure it would have been a while. Although back then, I think it took a lot longer for stuff to come to home video. So maybe it was new to video by the time I saw it. I don't know. But I remember Science World had like an aliens exhibit where I don't know if it was the actual animatronic or if it was just a replica, but it was like supposed to be the alien queen thing that they wore. And I remember us going to see it, me and my parents. And I think I would have watched the movie probably around that same time. I think both my parents would have been like, now let's give you some context, don't. And I know I saw the first Alien at a pretty young age as well, but whether or not it was the first, I don't know. But I definitely started younger than I think a lot of people do. I mean, that's actually totally valid, because those are a lot more likely to actually happen. Perfectly rational fear to have. Well, that line was stressful, but I got it. Don't worry, everybody, I got it. Boom. Pulled it off. Just barely. By the skin of the teeth. Now we have to do it again, but this one's less intimidating. You can do this one in pieces. Let's make that bottom edge a little bit thicker. By the way, the keyword for tonight's music was scary. Has anyone been scared from this music? I don't know if I got nightmares from it, but I liked. What did you like better, Dante's Peak or Volcano? I remember being more excited for Dante's Peak, but ultimately liking Volcano more. Speaking of which, right before I went live, Brad sent me a, that's BC Bot Killer, if he happens to be, that they're talking about Twister 2 and Helen Hunt might return. Twister, I think, might be the first time I picked up a movie reference from another movie in a movie. Which is part where, like, the guy yells out, "That's no moon, that's a space station!" And I was like, "What? That's from Star Wars!" And I don't think I've had ever noticed that in a movie before. They would reference another movie like that. I was a little young for Tarantino at that age. That's my memory of Dante's Peak as well. Twister's one I would watch again. I remember my, like, I don't think my parents were super into it, which might have colored my opinion of it at the time. Because I don't remember ever really disliking it, but I also don't remember ever having, like, a glowing opinion of it either. It's kind of a neat. I noticed her sword handle, kind of the riveting on it, reminds me a lot of Blade's sword handle. Hey, J-Hug. Thank you. Are you a Walking Dead fan? I was talking about it earlier, and I am a fan, but I kind of came to it late, and I watched it as a drawing show. I had it on the background while I was working on stuff. So I like it, but some diehards might consider that sacrilege. I don't know. Okay. I've still never watched Supernatural, and I wanted to watch it as my drawing show. I think they pulled it from Netflix, though, but I think that was my intention. I think it was, you know, I don't know how long ago now, but I had it on my list to watch whenever I finished whatever I was working on or watching then, and then it wasn't there when I tried to do it. At least I think. That might have been a while ago. Maybe it's back by now. There's some shows I would much prefer to watch at full attention, but also just know that there's just so much stuff to watch that it might not happen if I don't multitask. But there's some shows I will make a point of waiting to give my full attention to. It is on Netflix. Oh, but you're in the States though, aren't you, J-Hug? Where are you again? Right, okay, yeah. Yeah, we're in Vancouver, Canada here. British Columbia. They are done now, though, I think, right? Oh, really? Oh, shit. like revival or straight up reboot, like starting from scratch, new actors and the whole nine yards. Okay. Who are John and Mary? Are they their parents? Like, I've never watched a single episode of the show. Laughter. Do not be scared, folks. Just repeat to yourself, it is only a soundtrack. It is only a soundtrack. It is only a soundtrack. Okay. Oh, wow. Already launched. So there probably is a trailer, J-Hug. Otherwise, their marketing team has some explaining to do. There's a ripple going on the page here. That's weird. Wait, I heard about that. I didn't know that was them. That was a Supernatural spinoff, though. So their last name is the Winchesters? Is Winchester? Is it related to the Winchester? As in the supposedly haunted mansion in the States? I gotta assume that was at least an inspiration for the name, but whether or not they actually incorporated it into the plot, I mean. That's cool. Are they supposed to be descended from the family that built the house or whatever? By the way, side note, I thought the movie Winchester was super lame. I was very disappointed in that. The original one's a little slow by modern standards. I have not watched the new one yet. I actually kind of forgot. Is that on Disney Plus, by the way, Billy? It's a Hulu original, right? And we probably don't have that here. Even Prey, I think, was on Hulu in the States. if you didn't know, Jack, most stuff comes out simultaneously here it says in the States. It's just that if we don't have the same streaming service, it ends up somewhere different than where some of the promos might say. I don't want to misrepresent like we're way behind you guys or anything. Although I'm sure you already knew that. So where did you watch it, Billy? Oh, I thought you had. Weren't you the one that posted about it? Or somebody, who was it that posted about that then? Oh, it was JC, that's right too. He probably pirated it. Lousy thug. Yeah, I still haven't gotten to that yet, but I will probably get to that soon now that I've done the other stuff. I jumped into Friday the 13th first because I wanted to binge it, and I wanted to take advantage of the opportunity I had on Sunday night. But I will probably do Werewolf by Night and get caught up on Andor again probably pretty soon. Have a favorite horror movie, J-Hug? Or anybody else is watching? I probably asked you before, Billy, but I forget. offhand what the answer is. So also feel free to answer. Although I want to say it was either Alien or John Carpenter's The Thing. I could be wrong. John Carpenter's The Thing is my favorite. For anybody keeping score. I have not. I have... Sweet Home is on my list. I remember you talking about the other two, but I don't know if I have them on my officially on my list or not. But I haven't watched them yet, no. I was not shy about Friday the 13th earlier. I've been watching all of them the last couple days. Saw, I like the first Saw a lot. I like the second Saw. I was so-so on the third Saw, and I haven't caught up since. I kind of fell behind on them as they were coming out. And that's another one I've been wanting to do a catch-up on for a while. I rewatched the first one not that long ago, though. The first one really is really good. Like James Wan. That guy's going places, I tell you. Okay. Upside down jeans inking. John Carpenter's The Thing would probably be my favorite. It's just all those creepy, cool, practical effects. I would recommend it. Make sure it is the 1982, I think it is. John Carpenter's The Thing. And not the... There was a kind of a prequel, sort of, they did in, I think, 2012, which honestly isn't that bad. But it's not... It's also not great. It's just okay. And the original one is much better. Well, actually, even the original one is a remake. It's a remake of The Thing from Another World. But they're so different that it's barely even a remake. It's just kind of the core concept done differently. So I start with the 82. If you like it, Then maybe watch the prequel, see how you feel about that. But they called the prequel The Thing again for some stupid reason. So it could be it could easily get mixed up, which is why I give the warning. Okay. Did you like Dr. Sleep? Did you see Dr. Sleep? I was pretty impressed with that. I thought that was pretty good. It's a little long, but that was pretty good. Shone's done. We gotta get the other. Gotta get our actual Walking Deads in here. Okay. Have you seen A Cure for Wellness? It starts out very Shining-esque. And it eventually ends more like a Hammer horror movie. If you know the Hammer horror movies from like the 50s and 60s, it might be worth a shot if you're looking for more Shining-esque horror movies. I've only seen it the one time. I should watch it again, actually. See A Cure for Wellness, Billy? It's by Gore Verbinski guy, by the way. Guy did the Ring remake and Pirates of the Caribbean movies, the first three. Among other things. It's probably his biggest claims to fame, though. What's that link you just posted, Billy? I feel like Michonne and Blade would get along well together. Oh, cool. Apparently the new Blade is having some production problems. Totally. Oh yeah, I was thinking that not long ago. Yeah, I haven't seen it in a long time, but I like Lost Boys as well. Okay. Did you say you hadn't watched the show yet, Billy, or you had? I can't remember. I'm talking about it not long ago. I think you had, but you weren't caught up on it yet. I think that's what it was. Right. And are you working on that right now? Thank you. fairly early into the season, if I'm remembering right. So high up, I was probably holding up just there. Actually, speaking of Lost Boys, this music kind of sounds like that a little bit. Was it No Time for Souls or something? How's it go? It's on Disney Plus here. I think it's FX. It's an FX show originally, I think, right? Maybe it's on Hulu there. There you go. And the show is good, by the way. Yeah. Hopefully they'll come here soon. Although I think it only just finished in the States though, right? So it might be a bit before it gets here. Stupid cough. I don't like it. Ooh, cool. I like the sound of that. One of my, well, if you don't know, I do a horror comic I put out online every year around Halloween. And one of the ones I did a couple of years ago had a creepy, had a fortune teller in it. And, like, not even in it that much. And it's not necessarily one of my favorite stories I ever did, but the whole reason I did it was as an excuse to do a creepy fortune teller. I just wanted to draw that image. Happy to inspire. Fortune teller was in the third one that I did, I think. I have the sixth one. I should be live tomorrow. getting there. The zombie details are a bit of a slog at this point. But we're getting there. We're getting up to 2 hours. We're getting close. Yeah, especially when it's doing the horror thing and it does these. Can you hear it right now? Probably kick back up in the next track, or maybe this one's almost done actually, I can tell. Then you might hear about it a bit, hear it a little bit easier. This one's building, I think. You can't hear it now, but you will soon. A sci-fi horror vibe from this tune. entrails. So many entrails. I feel like this music is making me think of something in particular, but I can't quite put my finger on it. I don't think it's alien, but it's like alien-esque. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'll probably be watching Jason X tomorrow. Jason X was so much better than I expected it to be. Like, I always liked Jason, but I remember when that when I first saw the trailer for that TV commercial or whatever, I was just like, Jason in space, really? This, I think they've jumped the shark here. And then I finally watched it when it was on TV, and I was like, this is actually super fun, actually. I'm actually glad they made this. So what was the tagline? Was it Evil Gets an Upgrade or something like that? All right, Spot Blacks. Let's wrap this up. Favorite Walking Dead character, J-Hug, for when you were watching? Yes, I do. And because I kind of finished a bunch of other stuff, I'm going to go back sometime soon and color a whole bunch of my past Twitch drawings. I'm going to prioritize these horror-ish ones, though, for the sake of the Halloween season. So probably I might be coloring this one as early as this weekend. Okay. Scissor 7, Billy? I don't know if I know what that one is. A horror movie? Okay. Is that pretty new? Did it just drop? Oh, shit, okay. What made you think of it just now? Is it related to anything we were talking about? Not that you can't switch topics at any time, of course, I'm just curious. asked what favorite Walking Dead character. But I wasn't sure if you would have one. I was directing it. If you have one, Billy, I would love to hear it. But I was directing it a bit more at J-Og because he's watched a little bit deeper. Thank you, J-Hawk. And gotcha. I missed your earlier response there. Really sorry about Netflix. Almost there, but not quite. Okay. We are done, guys. This is time for a signature. There we go. It was Michonne from The Walking Dead. Let's raid somebody. Before we head out. So as usual, guys, don't need to stick around too long for the raid if you're not feeling it, but stick around long enough to give whoever we find a boost there. Thank you, Billy. And I'll be back on Thursday for I'm gonna do the character design challenge, but I'm gonna put a creepy twist on it to keep in the Halloween spirit of things. But let's find an artist to raid. Let's see who we got going here. Let's do, try to find somebody that's actually drawing. A lot of people are just talking and stuff. I can't tell what they're actually up to. All right, let's do Cody Shibi. He's not even here right now. God damn it. Okay, we got someone, okay, here we go. We're gonna do Sozo Meka. She's doing Catwoman by the looks of it. This looks cool. Okay. Oops. So. 3, 2, 1, race.